The third and last speaker of this session is going to be Maciej Dzierga. He's the CEO of STX Next, a software company from Poland. Over the past 9 years, Maciej has grown STX Next to the size of 100 Python developers. He's maintaining a team of Python superheroes in Poznan and other cities in Poland. And today, he is going to tell us how he wants to take his company to the next level. His talk is going to be about business development, about agile, and about team development. If the superheroes in Maciej's company have one superpower, then in my opinion, this is changing the rules of mathematics. In the abstract of the talk, it's said that 2 plus 2 can be much more than 4. Let's find out why. Welcome, How to Become an Agile Company, Maciej Dzierga.
Thank you very much. It will be quick talk because we have only 20-25 minutes, so I will be talking quite fast. Hopefully we'll have some time for questions at the end. So we have agenda, we have 7 points, so we don't have to go into details. More about me, my history. So I was Python developer, like most of you, for a couple of years. I started in 2004, and in fact, I was Plon developer. I came to Python as a Plon developer and then learned Python based on it. But quite fast, I noticed that I'm also good in management, so I get extra studies, courses in to learn management. So the key course was MBA in 2009, but later I noticed that we have to go into agile way, so I also took some certificates, agile certificates on Scrum Master and certified Scrum Product Owner. I'm still learning a lot, so future is in front of me. So it was just my quick history, so you know who I am, from where I am, and that I was Python developer for a couple of years. And I think I still know something about Python and how to program. But today, I don't program anymore. Today, I manage, and I'm a very big fan of Agile. And I'm going to tell you a little bit, not about Agile process in software development, but how I built STX Next, how I grow it, and how I want to do it in future. And I want to do it in Agile way. That's why we talk. I'm talking about agile enterprise, agile company, not agile software development. According to Business Directory, definition of agile enterprise is that this kind of company is, first of all, flexible. That is that it's able to respond, rapid respond to unexpected challenges. And today's world is full of unexpected challenges, events, opportunities, and agile companies have to respond to it quite fast. It's built on policies and processes that facilitate speed and change. Then it's characterized with diffused authority and flat organization structure. It's close, trusted-based relationship with their customers and suppliers. So this is what definition about agile enterprises. Then, of course, we have agile software development that is also crucial in context of agile company. We know about, most of you probably know that what is agile, that it's iterative, incremental, and evolutionary. So company can be also like this. It's based on efficient and face-to-face communication, a very short feedback loop and adaption cycle. So it was definition. This is Agile Manifesto. Probably a lot of you, if not all, know it, that Agile Manifesto value everything what is on the left. So individuals and interactions, working software, customer cooperation, and responding to change. And what we are trying to do in STX, we do it internally in the teams. We do Scrum, Kanban, Scrumban, so different implementation of Agile, but we also try to do it on company level, and I will share with you some nice stories that we had. We started long time ago, Westlake started long time ago in 2005, and we were almost agile at that time. Why? Because there have been only 5 developers, so there were no structure at all, so we can also say it was very flat structure, and this is agile. One client, very short feedback loop, very efficient face-to-face communication, of course, 5 people sitting in one room, almost in one desk, so there was no problem in communication at all. It's easy to communicate, but we also struggled with some problems. So we had no policies, no processes, no quality assurance, and we have a lot of problems with quality, most of all. Then a couple years passed, 2008. The new investor came to our company and gave us opportunity to work for very big projects for banks, biggest banks in Poland. We grew up to 10 people. It took us, as you can see, 3 years to grow from 5 to 10. Still, there were no structure, so almost agile, but we already had 5 clients, and we are able to take decisions very quickly. The other challenges and problems occurred, so we had no policies again, still no processes, no quality assurance, but we also started to face communication problems because there have been already 10 people and everybody was doing everything. So unfortunately, without specialization, we also came to, in some places, to poor execution. And then I discovered Agile. I read a lot of about it. I attended some conferences, courses. And what I found in Agile, the most important thing about Agile is that it's based on a couple of things. In Agile, you plan, do, inspect, and adapt. And this is how you can define Agile in very, very simple way with one picture. And this is how I was trying to build STX Next through many years. In different areas. The first area, the first problem was time tracking and how we implemented this agile cycle adaptation. So first the problem was employees didn't report worked hours, so we were not able to bill it properly to the client. I introduced company rule to report work hours in an Excel sheet for reporting. So we are able then to bill clients on it. But of course, the employees didn't follow that rule. So we created an app for reporting working hours, and we created daily reminders. So it was some kind of adaptation cycle. We found that people didn't report hours because they forget it, about it. So we tried to solve this with application. So it was better, but some people still didn't follow that rule. So we create policy that we pay only for reported work hours, and it really worked. Then, we also introduced flexible work hours. So we said, well, you can work in flexible way, but we will pay you only for the hours you reported. Additionally, we always have a policy that we pay overtime worked hours. But to be able to say that you have been working overtime, you have to report these hours. To then, at the end of the month, you say, well, I spent 10 hours more than expected, so you will get extra bonus for it. And now everybody reports work hours and no one complains about it. It's not that simple. It took us a couple of years to implement it, to find what is working, what is not working. But reminders are useful, but to change people's behavior, to change something, it takes time. And you also always have to find a good motivator to it. And yeah, this one was quite good. Today, we have 120 employees, and everybody is reporting hours very accurately each day. So this is quite nice. And I didn't heard since long time that anybody is complaining about it. So in the past, they complained a lot. The next agile way in the company is communication. So we started, you remember, 2005 with phone communication and different agreements. So nobody was knew what's going on in the company. Then clients denied that they agreed to something on the phone. People complained, so we introduced email and chat communication. That is improved something, so it was traceable. So there were history in logs, so if we agreed about some specification, some feature with the client on the chat, then or email, then you could always go back to it and confirm after a couple of weeks that it was agreed. But it was not enough. We have been growing, so it was difficult to know what's going on. So we implemented, we used existing ticket tracking system. That time, I think it was Track. We had a Flutter or Bugzilla or both. I think Jira was not there yet. So we had a fast list of tasks, problem with many projects, people, teams. It was much better than emails and chat, but still, when company was growing, we're not able to take good overview of projects. So what is nice, recently, a couple of years ago, what we implemented is board, agile board, so Scrum, Kanban board per team, per projects, and this is it is visible on the TV screen in every room. So we have a team in rooms, you will see it later on the picture, and we have on these TVs, we have team Scrum boards so, or agile boards that really shows a team where they are, what they are doing, and I can step into any team, any room, and can see what's going on in the project and that everything is under control. The problem was then when we have to also improve that we had the same Scrum Scrum board for all teams, for each team. So it was, let's say, backlog in progress to test and delivered or to production, to deploy and closed. The problem is that our team are unique, so each team is different. Each team works for different clients, different project, and they also implement different agile process. And it was a problem because not all the teams, some teams are doing Scrum Ban, some the other teams are doing Kanban, the other teams are doing something different. So what we created in our app, in our internal app, because we created it on our own, I think it was implemented in Pyramid, we created customizable Scrum Kanban boards with colors. So we have user stories with colors, and each team can map their process, very agile process on their screen. So right now we have the same tool, but each team can see something different, can see different Scrum. And it also took us a couple of years to come to the point where we are now, that each team can customize their Scrum board or Agile board to their needs, to their process and their working agreements. But all of them have a TV screen, or most of them in their rooms, and they can visualize work, they can see it all the time. What is, in my opinion, the most important part of Agile, of Scrum, are retrospectives. And retrospectives, according to Wikipedia, are meeting held by the project team at the end of project or process to discuss what was successful, what could be improved, and how to incorporate to success and improvement in future. So it's all about improvement, continuous improvement, some kind of Kaizen approach. And what I found out is I decided to implement retrospectives on the company level. We do every quarter company retrospective, so all team leaders gather in one room and do a retrospective on the company level. So we have every quarter team representatives. We talk about improvements in the company, in the processes, on different levels, on communication level. And examples on improvements from the last couple of retrospectives you can see here. So our people, team leaders, team representatives communicated to me, found out on the retrospectives that what they would like to change in the company is simplifying reporting time in the app. It was one thing of the thing I mentioned before, but they want the ping pong table, and they've got it at the end, that they would like Scrum in all projects, all teams. It was not like that in all the time. Today we have Agile in all the teams. That they want a separate room for one-on-one meetings, that they want anti-stress balls, that they want more light on the staircase, that they want teacups with STX superheroes. You can see these teacups on our booth, I think downstairs, so you will see how nice teacups we have. And this is the idea from our employees. And they want better Scrum board. We, of course, implemented that we can customize Scrum boards. It was also from inside company. The other agile thing, another feature of agile company is open communication. What I understand from company point of view is open communication. So open space is not open communication. What I believe that a team to become the real team, that that team dynamics will be in place, is that team is gathered in one place. So our work organization, office organization is like this, that one team is in one room. In most cases, we are able to locate the entire team in one room. Then really incredible things going on when people spend together 8 hours, they can solve all the problems. They can create nice things that are very innovative. They help each other and they also joke each other. They challenge each other. They motivate each other. So this is what I understand by open communication. And this is, I think, is most important, and it applies to all our teams. Then we have, of course, conference room that is available for all teams, that they can communicate outside their team with client, or they can do retrospective outside their room. What is the nice thing, and I find it that improves a lot communication, are lunches with colleagues. And what we have, and we always had in STX since the beginning, is that people lunch together in the lunch room in our office. So they don't usually go outside, but food is coming to our company and they spend 15, 20 minutes together eating. Eating together really builds very strong relationship, and this is a very unique thing that happens there. We have one-on-one room, people meet. Of course, we have regular things like group chat, Skype, Jagger, and so on. Why 1 plus 1 can be more? It's because we believe in teams and we delegate responsibility a lot of responsibility to team and team leaders. Our teams are self-organizing, they are co-located, entire team in one room. We have at least one woman in per team, and this is also, I think, quite unique about us. We have also one team compound only from women, so this is nice. We have always one non-technical person in the team, and team built their own agreement. Having this all in place, our team usually are much more efficient than team on client's side. We also use Agile in non-technical projects, Scrum board and Kanban board. So we implemented some extra features, so something like Kanban lanes to Scrum board. And what we manage, for example, with this kind of Scrum board is our marketing department and communication. So we have different communication to Facebook, LinkedIn, and we manage this process and this it's process more than a project, just with our regular Scrum and Kanban board. And then I can easily go into this kind of board and see what is the progress in our communication on in other things in the company. Today, company is more than 115 people. We are divided into around 15 teams. We have locations in 3 cities in Poland, Piła, Poznań, and Wrocław. We are also opening a new office in Łódź. We also have an office in Austin, in Texas. By the way, probably you are not familiar because you are from Europe, me also. Austin is small Silicon Valley, so small California, and now really a lot of innovative teams are located not in California, but in Austin. And it's much more cheaper, so it's wise to know. I didn't know when I came there, this is what I learned. We have 16 clients, most of them are in the United States and United Kingdom. We have also clients in the Netherlands. And of course, we have some clients, usually these are banks in Poland. How STX is going to be tomorrow? I don't know, but what I know is that we are going to follow all the time an agile process. So we'll be planning, doing, inspecting, and adapting all the time. We'll see what future will come. And now, if you have any questions, I will be happy to answer them.
Okay, first question, please, here.
I'm a Scrum Master, and I would say I have no idea why you introduce time tracking as a way to do a job. I really don't understand what's the agile.
Okay, so why was time tracking introduced as an agile practice?
Yeah, time tracking was key selling point for us because we need to have it because this is how we bill our clients based off on time and material. What we need as an agile, we improved our time tracking process inside company and we improved it in agile way. But this is not part of Scrum or agile itself. This is the business requirement. And we found a way, thanks to agile and retrospectives and adaption, how to make this less painful as possible. So it's not part of Scrum, but without good time tracking, you cannot run business very well because otherwise you don't know how to, you know, for example, count velocity per hour. This is we can do some extra measurements with it. But main reason for time tracking is billing, invoicing clients. You can always find me in our STX Next booth downstairs. I will be there for the next 1 or 2 hours. Unfortunately, I have to leave today afternoon. And one more thing. We are organizing, probably if you know, EuroPython Battle. So you are invited today at 4 o'clock. There will be another competition. So just join us downstairs. You will see what also nice things we are doing. Thank you.